This is the fourth and final part of the convex optimization series. In this video, we will look at the Slater's condition and the KKT condition. Rather than mathematical proof, let's try to understand them intuitively through simple examples. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice was generated using AI text-to-speech. First, let's look at the basic concept of the complementary slackness through simple examples. Next, let's look at the Slater's condition that can guarantee strong duality. And let's take a look at the Karush-Kuhn-Tucker or KKT conditions. Then we will use the KKT method to solve optimization problems with equality and inequality constraints. Lastly, we use the CVXOPT library to solve the QP and LP problems. Let's look at the basic concept of the complementary slackness. First, let's look at the two examples below. These examples have already been addressed in the second video. These examples are all optimization problems with an inequality constraint. In the second video, we used a slack variable and the Lagrange method to find the optimal solutions to these problems. You can solve an optimization problem with an inequality constraint. Or you can solve the problem by making it an equality constraint using a slack variable. We looked at all of these in the second video. Let's look at the first problem. The Lagrange primal function is like this. And the dual function is like this. And the optimal solutions are as follows. The optimal lambda is 0, and both x1 and x2 are 0. And the primal solution is also 0. If you use a slack variable, the epsilon will be 1. The optimal solutions for the second problem are that the lambda, x1, and x2 are all 1/2. And the primal solution is also 1/2. And the slack variable epsilon is 0. Here we can observe that when the lambda is 0, the epsilon is non-zero. And when the lambda is non-zero, the epsilon is 0. The epsilon and the lambda can be said to be complementary. So the lambda times epsilon is equal to 0. This is the basic concept of the complementary slackness. Then the equation below holds true. This part is the slack variable, epsilon. Let's put the optimal solutions to the first problem into this equation. Since the epsilon is not zero but the lambda is zero, this expression is zero. Let's put the optimal solutions to the second problem into this equation. The epsilon is 0 and the lambda is 1/2. And since the x1 and x2 are each 1/2, this equation also becomes 0. Therefore, we can see that this equation holds true for the two examples above. The complementary slackness is one of the KKT conditions that we will cover later. Let's look at the figure on the right. This straight line is the constraint. If the feasible region is to the right of the line, the epsilon is 0, and the lambda is non-zero. And if the feasible region is to the left of this line, the epsilon is non-zero, and the lambda is zero. Both the lambda and the epsilon can be zero. This is the case if the constraints are as follows. x1 equals x2. So it's a straight line passing through the origin. In this case, the optimal solution is the origin, whether the feasible region lies to the right or left of this line. In this case, both the epsilon and the lambda are zero. Next, let's look at the Slater's conditions. In general, the primal solution is always greater than or equal to the dual solution. This difference is called the duality gap. When the primal and dual solutions are the same, it is called strong duality, and the duality gap is zero. If the primal problem is convex, strong duality generally holds. This isn't always the case. Conditions that can guarantee strong duality in convex problems are called constraints qualifications. To better understand the convex optimization, we need to know the concepts of a fine set, a fine combination, a fine hull, interior, and relative interior, etc. These concepts are not covered here. This expression means that there exists the X belonging to the relative interior D. D is a domain, that is a feasible region, and the relative interior means the interior of the set D, which is not an empty set. This expression is an inequality, and this expression is a strictly inequality. And a straight line that passes through the origin is called a linear function. And a linear function with an intercept is called an affine function. Now let's look at the definition of the Slater's condition. The Slater's condition is a sufficient condition for strong duality to hold for a convex optimization problem. Below is an optimization problem. Here fx is a convex function. First, if there is at least one x that satisfies these conditions in the relative interior of the feasible region, strong duality holds. These conditions are that g of x is always negative, that is strictly feasible, and ax equals b. If gx is affine, feasible x is only required. That is, g of x can be equal to zero. In other words, if f of x is convex and g of x is affine, strong duality holds. Let's look at an example where strong duality holds. Let's look at this optimization problem. Fx is a convex function. There are two inequality constraints, g1x and g2x. Since fx is convex and the second constraint, g2x, is affine, g2x satisfies the Slater's condition. Therefore, we only need to check the first constraint. X are real values. And there are many real values where x squared are less than 1. For example, the squares of 0.1, 0.2, etc. are all less than 1. Therefore, this optimization problem satisfies the Slater's condition, and strong duality holds. Next, let's look at the Karush-Kuhn-Tucker, or KKT, condition. Rather than mathematical proof, let's briefly understand the KKT conditions. and see how to use them to solve optimization problems. There is an optimization problem below, and the Lagrange primal function looks like this. The lambda is the Lagrange multiplier for the inequality constraints, and must be greater than or equal to zero. The mu is the Lagrange multiplier for the equality constraints. Mu need not be greater than zero. The four conditions below are called KKT conditions. The first is the stationality. If you put the optimal solutions, x star, lambda star, and mu star, into the gradient of the Lagrange function, it should be zero. This is because the optimal solution is found so that the gradient is zero. The second is the complementary slackness, which we looked at previously. The third is the primal feasibility. This is the condition that the optimal solution, x star, satisfies all constraints. Fourth, the lambda must be non-negative. Let's look at the KKT conditions when f of x is not a convex function. For any optimization problem with differentiable objective and constraint functions, for which strong duality obtains, any pair of primal and dual optimal points must satisfy the KKT conditions. Next, let's look at the KKT conditions when fx is a convex function. When the primal problem is convex, the KKT conditions are also sufficient for the points to be primal and dual optimal. In other words, if f of x are convex, and hx are affine, and x star, lambda star, and mu star are any points that satisfy the KKT conditions, then they are primal and dual optimal with zero duality gap. Then strong duality holds. I referred to page 243 of this document. In summary, if fx is a non-convex function, KKT is a necessary condition for strong duality. If fx is a convex function, KKT is a necessary and sufficient condition for strong duality. Next, we will use the KKT method to solve the equality constrained optimization problem. We have the following optimization problem. There is one equality constraint. Since there is no GX, the first KKT condition is used. And in the third KKT condition, the condition where HmX star is zero is used. The Lagrange primal function looks like this. If we differentiate the primal function with respect to the x1 and x2 according to the first KKT condition, then x1 and x2 become the negative half of mu, respectively. And according to the third KKT condition, x1 plus x2 minus 1 equals 0. Since x1 and x2 are each negative half of mu, the mu is negative 1. Therefore, the optimal solutions x1 star and x2 star are each 1 half, and the primal solution p star is also 1 half. Next, we will use the KKT method to solve the inequality constrained optimization problem. The optimization problem is like this. And there is one inequality constraint. And the Lagrange primal function is like this. Finding the x1 and x2 with the first KKT condition gives the following results. And the second KKT condition, the complementary slackness, gives the lambda 0 or negative 1. the lambda of negative 1 is discarded because it violates the fourth condition. According to the third condition, minus lambda minus 1 is less than or equal to 0. Since the lambda is 0, it holds true. So the final lambda is 0. Then the optimal solutions to this problem are as follows. Next, we will use the KT method to solve the optimization problem of the inverse inequality. If we reverse the inequality of the constraint, the Lagrange primal function is as follows. According to the first condition, the x1 and x2 are each 1/2 of lambda. According to the second condition, the lambda is either 0 or 1. And according to the third condition, the lambda is greater than or equal to 1. The lambda of 0 is discarded because it violates the third condition. Then the final lambda is 1, and the optimal solutions to this problem are as follows. In this way, the optimization problem can be solved by following the KKT conditions. Next, we will solve the QP problem using the CVXOPT library. Since we already covered how to use CVXOPT in the previous video, we will only check the results here. There is a quadratic programming QP problem like this. There are two inequality constraints and one equality constraint. If we define each matrix like this and find the optimal solutions, the results are as follows. Let's run this code. The results as follows. Lastly, we will solve a linear programming LP problem using the CVXOPT library. This problem has 4 inequality constraints and 1 equality constraint. If you define each matrix like this and run the SolveLP function, you will get the following results. Let's run this code as well. The results are as follows. So far, we have briefly looked at convex optimization through a total of 4 videos.